Hi, my name is Greg here at Worcester Technical High School in Worcester, Mass. We're on our third video of our mini angle grinder series. If you want to see how the tool runs, stay tuned. So here we are on how to use our mini angle sander. We're going to start off on our roof rack here, which is carbon steel. And we have some welds here we want to shine down and flatten out. So I'm going to use the sanding disc first. I'm going to use that on these welds that you can see. And I'm going to polish them down until this is flat and I can't see any divots. And that's when I'll know to go to switch the wheels into the non-woven abrasive wheel to shine this up for painting. So that sanding process may take anywhere from 15 minutes to a half an hour. With this size of abrasive wheel and on this roof rack, I would say probably a half an hour, because you have a little bit of grinding here. And on the back of these letters where you've cut, there's gonna be some slag. And the size of this wheel and the speed of that will take a little bit of time, but it'll be nice because you can get some finesse with that angle grinder. So what's great about this mini angle sander is you don't have to add a lot of pressure. And that's actually one of the worst things to do to a grinder. You wanna have some finesse and be able to use it really soft. I also like that these wheels bend a little bit. And when you are light like that, you can go around these corners, because if you put too much pressure on it, where this roof rack kind of has a lot of angles and it's thinner, you may get the grinder stuck. And I don't know if anybody's ever ground anything and you get the grinder stuck. When they're spinning at 25,000 RPMs, they'll rip right out of your hand and kind of scare you and maybe wreck your grinder. So you don't ever want to bear down too hard. These wheels are really great and they work really well. So let the wheel do the work. You don't have to do the work. While I'm using this disc, I can move on. I don't have to worry so much because I know I'm going to paint this because it's carbon steel. But if I was going to work on aluminum or stainless steel, something like that, I may want to grind down a little bit more and make it a little bit more polished, because that's something that won't get painted and it won't be able to hide it. So you may want to get as much stock removal as you can with this before you move on to the non-woven sanding disc. So if you are sanding something where it does matter if you have those gouge marks in, sometimes between this backing strip and this pad, it can be like a little aggressive and not have as much give. So that if you use a wheel like this, where it's a little bit thicker and it has some give, and you come into these angles, this wheel would work a little bit better and would have a lot less gouging on it. And if you go nice and light, you could maybe even polish it enough where you don't need another wheel afterward. So if you guys have any tips you'd like to add, add those to the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe.